Hello friends, welcome to this video on quadrilaterals. In the previous video, we solved some questions related to the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. In today's video, we will discuss some more facts based on the same topic and increase our knowledge on this subject. So let's start this session with a question. Look at the given figure and find the measure of angle Y. Friends, here we are given the measurement of two internal and one external angle of the quadrilateral, and we have to find the measurement of the remaining one angle. Here we will first find the measure of angle W. We know that when an angle forms a complete circle, its measure is 360 degrees. Therefore, the sum of the measurements of exterior angle XWZ and interior angle XWZ will be 360 degrees. We are given the measurement of the exterior angle XWZ as 290 degrees. Using this, we can find the measure of the interior angle XWZ. We got the measure of the interior angle XWZ as 70 degrees. Now we have the measurement of the three interior angles of the quadrilateral. We can easily find the measurement of the fourth angle in this way. We got the measurement of angle Y as 60 degrees. Let's take one more question. Friends, to show or prove the angle sum property of the quadrilateral, we have divided it into two triangles. With the help of the same concept, find the angle sum property of a hexagon. Friends, how do we solve this question? Pause the video and think about it. Here, the first task will be to construct a triangle by drawing a line from any one vertex to another non-adjacent vertex in such a way that the lines do not intersect each other. And then, see how many triangles we are getting. And then, multiply the number of triangles obtained by 180 degrees. The product obtained will be the sum of all the angles of a hexagon. You can see that we have got four triangles. That is, the sum of all the angles of a hexagon will be 4 multiplied by 180 degree is equal to 720 degrees. Let's see another interesting question of this type. How many maximum acute angles will be needed to construct one quadrilateral? Friends, you can also pause the video to think about the answer to this question. We have to see whether it is possible to construct a quadrilateral in the given three situations. Let's take the first option and take a group of four angles such that there is only one acute angle like this. We can see that the construction of a quadrilateral is possible here. Similarly, for the remaining two options also, let's create a group of angles in such a way that there are two and three acute angles respectively. You can still see that the construction of a quadrilateral is possible. According to the question, we have to find the maximum number of acute angles, so the correct option will be 3. But friends, is it possible to construct a quadrilateral from 4 acute angles? You can throw light on this with the help of your teacher and classmates. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discuss some facts related to the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. See you in the next video. Thank you.